स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दम् कृपापूर्णम् जगत्पतिम् हरिषड्वर्गजेतारम्।
Here the sutra which Shiva says, look lovingly at some object. Do not go to another object. Here in the middle of the object, let the blessing happen to you. You see, you do not even have to choose a deity. You can choose anything with which you feel connected. If it is Coca-Cola bottle, okay. But the problem is, with Coca-Cola bottle, you will have only lust, not love. When you see that bottle, you will think only, what I can get out of it. Understand? Looking with love and looking with lust are two different things. When you see a beautiful man or woman, when you look, you only look what I can get out of that person. Then it is looking with lust, not with love. Love means what I can add to that person. What way I can be of some help to that person. If you decide or think of adding something, then it's looking with love. The moment you see and you start calculating what I can get out of that person, it is looking with lust. Understand, looking with love, looking with lust, two different things. Here Mahadeva says, not only two different things, diametrically opposite. Here Mahadeva says, look lovingly at some object. If you use the divine objects, it is lot more easy, because the possibility of lust is less. Possibility of love is more. From the young age, you are taught to look with a love and respect. So it is easy to connect. It is easy to relate. Have any one deity or the photograph of the god or guru. Try to look with a deep love without moving to the other object. Understand? That is the main. That is the basic thing. Do not move to the other object. The moment you start jumping to the other object, you are tired of this object. The love has disappeared. Understand? As long as love is there, that object is unique, not number. Not number. For example, if you are just a worker, maybe a clerk or a attendant, just a clerk in the office, if you die, nothing will stop. Somebody else will come, replace you, the job will continue, life will continue. You are just an utility, number, figure, that's all. But if somebody is in love with that same clerk, if the clerk dies, that person will never be again the same. Wherever you are just a number, even if you die, that mechanism will not suffer. Wherever you are in love with some object or person or somebody is in love with you, you become unique. Naturally, your death cannot be replaced. That person will miss you. That person's life will never be the same again. Love makes things unique. Love makes things unique. The other day, we were having an energizing ceremony here in the temple. All the swamis, all of us are sitting and before preparing for the ceremony. One disciple, she asked me, Swamiji, every day you are seeing us. all our mistakes, confusions. Are you not bored by us? It was a very honest question. Because they know if sometime I tell them, do some new mistake, I'll be entertained. Not the same mistakes. Because even to commit new mistakes, you need intelligence. She was asking that, don't you feel bored? I told, just because of my very love, I feel everybody is unique. Understand, I do not look upon the devotees or disciples as number. It is unique. That is why with so much of patience, I continue to work with everybody. If it is just a number, forget about it. Next person will do the work. Over. Devotees or disciples are not number for me. Because of my love for them, they are unique. Everybody is unique. Of course, I never miss anybody. Just because of complete fulfillment. But otherwise, everybody adds something. Everybody is welcomed, is expected, is needed, is wanted, is required to be here. Every individual is unique. Same way, when you are in love with the Master, he is needed, he is unique. When that love is not there, one more Swami, we can go to the other Ananda, what is there? If you just type only Nityananda, at least 200,000 websites are opening. Just Nityananda. If you type Swami Nityananda, I don't know how many million websites will open. And if he is not, then some other Swami, that's all. If you are a number, you can be replaced. If the love, element of love comes to play between you and the other person, you are no more a number. You are unique being, irreplaceable, unique being. Love adds life even to the person. With love, the person is a spirit, life. Without love, the person is reduced to a thing, utility. Without love, when you look at somebody, a beautiful man or woman, and planning for what I can get out of that person, you are reducing him to a thing, not as a being, as a spirit. Only when you look at that person with a love, he is a spirit, he is a living being. When that love is not there, he is a thing. That is why, whenever people look at you with a lustful eyes, you feel repulsive. It looks ugly. You just cover yourself. You just hide yourself. You want to move out of that place. Whenever somebody looks at you with a deep love, you just feel like being around that person continuously. Even if you get only one glimpse, one eye contact with him, you will be waiting for it. You will be just waiting for that one contact. Just waiting for that one glimpse, one look. It's a love which adds value to the uniqueness. Another one incident. At least with that Krishna incident which I said, it was a deity. It was a carved Krishna Murti. That is okay. There is another one small incident happened. I was traveling. I don't know which place. Maybe around the area of Madhya Pradesh or Maharashtra. There was one small tree, and under the tree the three bricks which is used for construction is kept with a turmeric powder applied on it and some puja being done. Usually in the evening time when I rest, I'll search for some brick for the head to keep the head and lie down. I saw that area, nobody was there, just the three bricks were there. And I did not know that it was being worshipped by some villager as a deity. And I just took that, picked up that brick and put it for my head and lie down. And really, in 10 minutes, one village guy, elderly person, is running towards me. His house was maybe 1 mile away. He ran towards me and when he came near me, he understood I am a sadhu. Because I was a sadhu, he did not beat me. He told, "Do you know this is Shiva? I worship." He appeared in my dream and told that you are lying on him. Truth, really. Understand? So that's why I came here. And he brought a small pillow. That's another beautiful thing. He brought a pillow. Lie down on this pillow and leave him there. Put that murti back. From 1 mile, he was lying down in his home. He says, "I had a dream. Shiva told me that one sadhu is lying on me. Take that." And he brought the pillow and told me to put the brick the other side. We don't know who all are having connection to what all. Just his deep love for that ordinary brick, which is used for construction, can create a telepathy power in him. Understand? I read an article. American army is trying to develop telepathy power to use during the war times. They are doing some research and development to use this telepathy, sending message through the mind. Understand, ordinary villager, just his love for a brick. Of course, I am afraid to use the word brick again now. He may get a... I don't think he is dead. Only that elderly lady was dead. I don't think he is dead because I never tried to trace him also. Anyhow, just simple love to the ordinary looking brick can create such a deep telepathy connection between him and Mahadeva. Then understand, between him and Shiva, this ordinary brick is acting like a cell phone. You can't imagine the way in which that guy ran towards me and the way in which he was shouting at me. Just because I am a sadhu, he left me. Otherwise, I would have had the puja. The puja from him. Just I want all of you to understand the power of love. The power of simple love. It was a simple love. And actually, during British time, all the milestones in the Indian highway used to be yellow painted. There was a big problem because from next day, all the local villagers started worshipping all the milestones. No, really. Then they changed the color and changed it to green paint. Because for Indian villages, nothing is needed. Just a clear, some shape is enough. Everything is God for us. Everything is God for us. Let me describe this incident that may throw a deeper light for you. It was a very intimate discussion between me and one of my enlightened disciples. Maybe, if you are new, you should know, few of my disciples had the fortune and had the enlightenment experience. Not only had, of course, enlightenment once happens, it stays with you. He was asking me, "Swamiji, after this experience, whatever books I read, many points I can say are my experience, but many points are not my experience. How can I understand whether I am fully enlightened or not? Or how is that points? Are they right or wrong?" There is a very beautiful incident in Ramana Maharshi's life. I quoted and gave him the answer. Understand, this one incident can completely open up and give you a new click or new glimpse towards the truth. Ramana Maharshi says in his teaching, when in his conversation, I never read any spiritual literature or the literature related to spiritual knowledge except one or two book before enlightenment. He says, I achieved the Brahman Jnana without knowing the word Brahman. And after I achieved the experience, when I was going through the books, I was able to clearly experience whatever is written is my personal experience. This was the discussion he was doing. Later on, some disciple asks him, Bhagavan, how can every word written in that book can be your personal experience? He was bringing up some point in that book. It is written like that, some traditional book. Enlightened masters can do all this. But in your experience, you are not doing all that. Some materialization or miracles. Bhagavan says, when I say all those things are part of my experience, my inner space is so vast, I can see very clearly, including materialization, everything can happen. It is not necessary that I should do it and show. But in my inner space, I can see very clearly it can happen. Understand? If you have the clear confidence and feeling, yes, I can see the divine. It can happen in me. I have such enough inner space and love. Be very clear. Already you passed that state. You passed that much. You can now start the next level. You can now start the next things. You don't need to sit there and prove. Sitting there and proving is only needed as long as you have doubt. You have doubt. Bhagavan says very beautifully, I am very clear. The materialization can happen inside my inner space. I can very clearly do. That is the reason. I don't have to prove myself or to prove to others that I can do. I asked him, do you have that clarity? He said, yes. I do. I am very clear. I can do it. Only thing, the feeling is not coming up strongly from the navel center. That any thought has to come from the navel center, only then you will be able to execute. That is not happening. But the possibility is there inside the body. I can feel very clearly. My nerves are saying it is possible in me. See, your nerves will never tell lie to you. Your mind will tell lie to you. But never your body. Your nervous system will never tell a lie to you. Your nervous system can never tell false things to you. He said, I am very clear. I can do that. Then that's all. You do not have to prove. Understand, when you have this love, your inner space will become such. There are many things you will not ask to be proved. You will not asking for the clear logical reason. Suddenly you will just feel connected. That's all. People who cannot experience, understand the space of being in love with the master, cannot understand the truth. That's why I always tell, we are not cult, we are a culture. Understand, there is a big difference between these two. There's a big difference between these two. When you are in deeply love, you will see the uniqueness of the truth. And everything will become alive, reality to you. And you will see every step you take in your life feels ecstatic, feels joyful. I cannot imagine from 1 mile somebody running with a pillow saying that you are sleeping on my God. Understand the strong telepathy connection with an ordinary brick. I am sure nobody saw and called him in cell phone, because those days there was no cell phone in the villages. And surely nobody can see and go and tell him. And if somebody went and told him, he would have only brought the stick, not the pillow. But he brought the pillow. He says, Shiva told me, you are lying on him. You have the pillow and leave him, put him there, back in his place. Love can create such a deep connection, and it can open up many dimensions in you. It can awaken many possibilities in you. So understand this technique. You can try even in this next gap. You will have a small break. Every day we will see two sutras. Two sutra and a small break. We will have even this small break. Try to go and sit in front of any one deity which you really love, or any other object which you really feel loving. Sit in front of it. Look very deeply, lovingly. Just became look. Let your consciousness be completely centered on your eyes. Let your hand, leg, body, everything lose its very existence. Let you forget about all those things. Let everything disappear. Let you just become eyes. Look deeply with a deep love for few minutes without jumping into the other object. If you jump to other object, come back. Get back. And just sit with a deep love, completely in a relaxed way, you will see a very deep silence, very deep bliss, very deep blessing starts coming out of your system. You need to understand one more thing. All techniques can lead only to peace. When the peace settles inside your system, bliss will explode. Do not expect the bliss which is being expressed or shown in my body language. Meditation will lead you only to peace. And when the peace settles inside your system, when your nerves are clean, when your nervous system is cleaned by the peace, the settling peace, the bliss will explode. You will start expressing the bliss which is expressed in the master's body language. Try this meditation technique with any one deity, with a deep love and silence. Let the blessing happen to you. Let the blessing happen to everyone. We'll have a small break, and after that we'll have the next session, the next sutra, and few of your question answers. If you have any question, you can drop, leave your questions here. I'll answer. Let's gather for next session. Thank you. Shivoham, Shivoham, Shivoham.